On the morning of July 25th, 2012, my life was turned upside down in a matter of hours. FBI agents from around Washington and Oregon and Joint Terrorism Task Force agents from Washington busted down the front door of my house with a battering ram, handcuffed my housemates and me at gunpoint, and held us hostage in our backyard while they read us a search warrant and ransacked our home. They said it was in connection to May Day vandalism that occurred in Seattle, Washington earlier this year. However, we suspected that this was not really about broken windows. As if they had taken pointers from Orwell's 1984, they took books, artwork, and other various literature as evidence, as well as many other personal belongings, even though they seemed to know that nobody there was even in Seattle on May Day. While we know that knowledge is powerful, we suspected that nobody used rolled-up copies of the Stumptown Wobbly to commit property damage. We saw this for what it was. They are trying to investigate anarchists and persecute them for their beliefs. This is a fishing expedition. This is a witch hunt. Since then, thanks to a Freedom of Information Act request, we have learned that this grand jury was convened on March 2, 2012, 2 months before the May Day vandalism even took place. I was served a subpoena to testify before a grand jury on August 2nd, a week later. I hastily packed up my life into boxes, got rid of almost all of my personal belongings in preparation of incarceration. I was dismissed that day after refusing to testify and re-subpoenaed for August 30th, which was pushed back to September 13th. In that time, I did a lot of self-care, got my affairs in order, and got advice from people who had either resisted grand juries, gone to prison, or both. I returned to the grand jury on September 13th, where I was granted immunity. When you are granted immunity, you lose your right to remain silent and can be thrown into prison for civil contempt. Between consulting with my attorney and an hour-long recess, I narrowly avoided a contempt hearing simply because they ran out of time. I was dismissed and was told I would receive my fourth subpoena. I walked out of the courthouse just in time to witness Matthew Kyle Duran, my fellow resistor, being taken away to prison in a police van. It broke my heart to watch them kidnap an amazing and strong person and take him away from his friends and loved ones. Catherine Cadio Olejnik has met a similar fate for refusing to testify on September 27th. Right now, Matt and Cadio are both sitting in prison cells for doing nothing but remaining silent. I have nothing but love and admiration for them both, and I know that thousands of others feel the same. On the drive home that night, my brain felt like it was short-circuiting. A few days later, I received notice that my next subpoena was for October 10th. They also notified my lawyer that they are preparing for a contempt hearing. Court dates aside, my life has been a roller coaster. Thanks to unrelated events, I have suffered with severe depression and PTSD for many years. These are now much worse and new things trigger me. For a while after the raid, I was in a constant state of panic and could barely eat. Every time someone knocked on the door, every time I heard any sort of loud sound in my house, my heart sank and I thought, they've come for me. To the day of this writing, I haven't slept a full night since that cold July morning thanks to nausea-inducing anxiety that wakes me up between 4 and 7 every single morning. After a couple months, the initial panic has faded into grim acceptance. Despite my mental health issues, I never once considered cooperation and never would. It is against everything I believe in. On my right arm, I have a tattoo reading, "Strive to survive, causing least suffering possible." This is something I live by every single day and will continue to live by whether I'm in a cage or not. I cannot express in words how grateful I am to all those who have shown us support and solidarity, especially our friends, partners, and loved ones. We will all get through this together. I know that I am a broken record with the following sentiment, but I feel like it's worth repeating. They want us to feel isolated, alone, and scared. I know that even though KDO is being held in what is essentially solitary confinement, she does not feel alone. I know that Matt does not feel alone. I know that I will not feel alone. When they try to mercilessly gut communities, we do not scatter, we grow stronger, we thrive. I view this state repression like this. The state thinks it is a black hole that can destroy whatever it wants. In reality, it is much more like a stellar nursery, wherein it unintentionally creates new, strong anarchist stars. I do not look forward to what inevitably awaits me today, but I accept it. I ask that people continue to support us through this process by writing us letters, sending us books, donating, and spreading awareness. My convictions are unwavering and will not be shaken by their harassment. Today is October 10th, 2012, and I am ready to go to prison. Love and solidarity to all those who resist. Forever in silence, Leah Lynn Plant.